Here I am again. I'd like to react on Dave Gahan's covers. And two of them I've already listened to. So we're going on with the next one. I didn't take out the lyrics, but I listened to the original versions from the songwriters and the singers like Elvis or some others. Let me just without preparation just react to Dave Gahan's covers, the songs. I'm sure they will be mind-blowing, but let's just listen. And I have just noticed by looking at them, some of them are really short, 2 minutes, 57 seconds, so about 3 minutes long. Some of them are 4 minutes, so I guess the longest one will be almost 5 minutes. I think it is Metal Heart. And the others, they are so short, I think. So anyway, wait a minute. If the advertisement goes away, of course. I hate advertisements. So let me just hide this. Okay. Now, I think it was. Oh God, I'm not sure which one it was. No, I think it was this one. Yeah, probably this part. Okay. If it chose YouTube. Well, it froze. That's bad. Why did it froze? Oh God, that's bad. Okay. What happened now? Well, why didn't it show YouTube here? Okay. Let me try again. Okay. Okay. I think it works now. So let's get started. The first cover is A Man Needs a Maid. I hope the lyrics are there and somebody uploaded them. So let's just listen.
Every moment together is a gift. Love
you, babe. You love Gantt charts? Here's how easily you can build one.
My life is changing in so many ways. I don't know who to trust anymore. There's a shadow running through my days, like a beggar going from door to door. I was thinking that maybe I'd get a maid, find a place nearby for her to stay. Just someone to keep my house clean, fix my meals and go away. A maid. Man needs a maid.
I have to stop it here. Yes, it starts very softly, slow. And when it comes to the refrain, where he says, a maid, a man needs a maid, voice, the noise, the musical instruments come together and form a very nice melody. I like the softness in Dave's voice. He gets so carried away, and he also carries fans away, listeners away. As I said, I can't have enough of his voice. It's so soothing. It soothes the soul when he sings, and it comes from the heart, as if he wants to tell that he needs a maid. And when he says, my life is changing in so many ways, I don't know who to trust anymore. And it's as if he is talking about his own life. So let's continue listening. It's such beautiful, such a wonderful song. The piano, it's the piano, right? The piano keys that are so stunning here. Wonderful, wonderful. I don't know who played the piano here, but definitely it's breathtaking. Together with the voice, a good harmony. It forms a good harmony.
It's hard to make that change when life and love turn strange. And
now here, there is a certain change. A change in the melody. A woman, a female voice comes in between, and also something about his life. Also, there is a shift of a certain change in his life as well. So as the woman steps in, the female voice, also a certain change in his life takes place. That's what I think. And because in the interview he said, this album is so honest. So I think it is all about his life that he's talking about here.
You've got to live a love. To live a love. You've got to be part of. When will I see you again?
Yes, when I hear this line, it reminds me of my own life. I mean, he's singing out here, when will I see you again? And that's what we ask ourselves, the fans, the devotees. When will we see you again, David? So that's what I always thought after each concert, when I saw them, when I saw him, and I asked myself, when will I see you again? I guess that was the last time I saw you. And then several other opportunities came up and I was able to see him again. So this is what I thought when I saw him in Gelsenkirchen. That was 2017, when I thought, okay, that's it. Over, everything over, and I'm supposed to get on the plane and turn back to Turkey. And but you unexpectedly you get to have certain chances in your life where you think, okay, why not? I mean, why not take the chance to see him in Krakow again, and then in Berlin, and that twice in the final concert in Berlin. So I saw him after that three more times, and so this line reminds me of so many fans asking now to themselves, to each other, when will we see Dave again? Yes. The piano is so beautiful, especially the piano here, right? Certain other sounds, musical sounds come together in harmony, but the piano stands out, definitely.
While I go somewhere I don't know. I was watching a movie with a friend. I fell in love with the actress. She was playing a part that I could understand.
Yes. And when you watch a movie, and when you fall in love with an actress, that also reminds me of devotees, fans, falling in love with singers, like we did. Where did the lyrics go? Ah, the lyrics went away. Okay, here they are again. Yes. So that's what these lyrics remind me of. So as you're watching a friend, a movie, as you're watching a movie with a friend, you fall in love with the actress because she played the part that you could understand. And in a way, it makes us think when we watch you on stage, something that you act out makes us understand. We feel the same, probably, or it is the same feelings that we share, probably, that I don't know what it is, but there is a certain bond between you and the fans that bring us together. So we ask ourselves, when will we see you again? And also, it makes me think, I fell in love with you. Okay. So, let's see.
When will I see you again?
Well done. The last line calls out for that that thirst of seeing that special person. When will I see you again? It's the same with us. It's the same with us. We're asking us this question too. When will we see you again? So beautiful. Beautiful. That's a very beautiful song. Too bad it is only 4 minutes something. So I wish there was a prolonged version of this. Yes, so beautiful. Now comes the next song. I hope I can download the whole part of the songs as a whole video, I mean. Let me just try. So the next song is well, okay. A man needs a maid. Now, Lilac Wine. As I said, I listened to the original songs, but that was months ago, and I don't remember who sang which song. So I didn't want to go into details. Just listen to the cover that Dave sang. Right? Now comes Lilac Wine. And I hope I can find the lyrics.
I lost myself on a cool, damp night. Gave myself in that misty light. Hypnotized by a strange delight. Under a lilac tree. I made wine from the lilac tree, put my heart in its recipe, makes me see what I want to see, be what I want to be.
Yeah, I couldn't find the lyrics, but I'm just listening to the voice now. Very romantic. As usual, let me just turn on the volume a little bit.
When I think more than I want to think, do things I never should do.
Yes, that's something, I guess that's something about his life and our lives. That's what we always do. We think and we do things that we shouldn't have done or shouldn't do. So it's all about life, actually, and that's normal, I guess.
I drink much more than I ought to drink. Because it brings me back you.
Okay. This must be something about his life again, and it makes me think. Is this a certain message that he's giving? I mean, is it real that he drinks more than he used to drink? And what happens when he drinks? Does it bring somebody back? This again takes me back to Berlin, to Mart's birthday, to his birthday day, the birthday evening after the concert, when we saw you.
Lilac wine.
I like this. It's getting faster. It's like a galloping horse. So very, very elegant. Put it a little bit forward. No, backward. Sorry.
It's sweet and heady like my love.
So he makes a connection between lilac wine and his lover. That's so nice. A resemblance of the two.
Lilac wine.
As if he's calling out for his love. His voice so romantic.
Unsteady, like my love.
So unsteady like my love. So he's describing the wine and his love. So they have the same characteristics. Yes, that's so nice. So nice.
Listen to me, I cannot see clearly. Isn't that she coming to me nearly?
So this sounds as if he's calling out for his love and he wants her desperately to come back, probably. So he's calling out for his love. And this gives you a certain feeling of a longing, right? You long for that moment to see your lover. So it's an endless longing.
Lilac wine.
And as you know, when he sings that, lilac wine, it's just one lilac wine. It's just three syllables, but they take you away to so many things, to romanticism, to beauty, to love, to all sensuality, everything, and erotic stuff.
It's sweet and heady. Where's my love?
Yes, he's calling out for his love. Where's my love? Yes, and it makes you sigh.
Lilac wine. I feel unsteady, Where's my love?
Yes, I love the vocalists as well. So today I was thinking it would be so great if I also sang as a vocalist for you. That would have been so romantic.
Listen to me. Why is everything so hazy? Isn't that she? Or am I just going crazy?
Yeah, it tells the lyrics when you can't reach your love. There is such a desperate longing that you go crazy. It's definitely madness.
Lilac wine, I feel unready for my love.
That's so lovely when he sings lilac wine, I'm so ready for my love. That means he is taking steps towards his love, so reaching out for her.
I'm ready for my love.
Beautiful. So beautiful. So beautiful. Thank you, Dave. That's wonderful. Okay, I hope wait a minute. Lilac wine, okay. Now I need to find the page again. Okay. Now comes the next song. The Desperate Kingdom of Love. It's so short. Oh, 2 minutes. 2 minutes, 57 seconds. That's the shortest song, I guess. Oh, God. Wow. Ooh, it starts heavy. So, wow. Wait a minute. I hope there are the lyrics. Wow. So, no lyrics. Wait a minute. So, it seems to me like a heavy metal song, or not that heavy, probably a hard rock. That's what I would say, a rocky song. So, where are the lyrics? No lyrics. Anyway, I'd like to listen, just listen and give out my ideas. So, but too bad, it's so short. Such a rocky song should definitely be longer. And I guess that's his writing, his handwriting at the corner. Okay, rocky mixed with blues. Very fine mixture. Very beautiful.
Oh, love, you were a sickly child. But how the wheel knocked you down. Put on your spurs, your swagger. the desperate kingdom of love.
So when he sings, oh love, blah, blah, blah, blah, you were a sickly child, I think he means his own childhood. I'm sure that most of us, some of us, they have had a similar childhood like his. I mean, not every childhood is easy. Some childhoods are definitely hard and you have to go through certain stuff. But that makes you stronger in later life. So as you go through hardships in early life, it makes you feel mature and it makes you feel mature in the latter life. So that's the wine that comes out, the good fine wine like Dave. Okay, and when he sings of mysterious eyes, I think he means his own eyes. So, because when you look at Dave's eyes, they are mysterious, they are deep. You sometimes get lost in his eyes. Yes. So even those mysterious eyes won't help you anymore. That's what he sings.
Selling your reason when I bring you through the desperate kingdom of love.
Okay, so that sounds like love will be so strong that it will swipe away or wipe away the mysterious eyes that are trying to hide. So love will reveal everything. Love will heal everything. Even the darkest sides of your life.
There's another who looks from behind your eyes.
Well, that's great. I mean, swinging part of the song, that's great. I mean, from the very beginning, it's something rocky, something bluesy. Very beautiful, the mixture together.
Desperate kingdom of love. At the end of this burning world.
So, on one side, there is a desperate kingdom of love, and on the other side, there is a burning world. So, the two contrasts and the two controversies. So one side, probably the water, and the other side is the fire. So the water will extinguish the fire, probably, and that will heal the soul. Oh, that's what I think. Okay, desperately, the world will not continue burning. And I think that everything will come to a halt, a beautiful ending. That's what I think.
I follow you into heaven.
Oh, and he says, I follow you into heaven or hell. So whoever you are, wherever you go, I will follow you. Wow, what a strength of love. Jennifer is so lucky. She has the man that we are all dreaming of. So that's what I can say in the name of the other fans, of course.
Desperate kingdom of love.
I think this song brought me to a very high degree. Somewhere I'm getting high. The highest point of the songs, probably. That's what I can say. Wonderful. So it's ending, it's also ending rocky, and it started rocky, that gave the certain kick to the song. Yeah, very, very beautiful. So, the next one. Now comes Shut Me Down. Yeah, very nice beginning again. Wonderful. And I hope I can see the lyrics. Wait a minute. I miss you so much. I miss you so much. Oh, no lyrics. But anyway. I miss you so much. Every wrote down, I miss you so much, but no lyrics. I miss you so much. We've missed you so much. Everyone misses you so much. No. No lyrics. Aww. Anyway, I will find the lyrics. I hope I can understand every word of the song. Wait a minute. I miss you so much. So much. That's from the heart. We miss you so much.
I miss you so much. I miss you so much. It's ragged ass, my nerves, and I agree. What I become is surely worth the hatred that
you spat on me, the sky above me, the night so deep that I could trip and drown, and still I see that you were dearly loved.
Wow, that's great. It starts with the dark, I miss you so much, and then it goes very rhythmic into the nice mixture of instruments and rhythmic melody of the song. I mean, probably the refrain. But I don't like this line. Something about shutting you down. But I'm sure probably some of your encounters would have wanted to shut you down. Who knows?
For so long, soldier, we're deep in Dutch. I can't ignore it.
I miss you so much.
I miss you so much.
We miss you so much. Right, and here the beating changes a little bit. I love that. How it goes over to the change of beat.
As ragged as my nerves are not free. What I've become is surely worth the hatred that you spat on.
Right, the voices, the sounds, they mix very much together. I can't make out what he's talking about here. But it's wonderful just to listen to the melody. Wonderful. Okay, he's talking about the blue sky above him, and then he sings of that certain person that she wants or he wants to shut him down.
I miss you so much. I miss you so much.
And the ones that I miss, they are so far away, in faraway land, in faraway continents. And there is only a sea actually combining us. Because most of the ones that I miss, they are in Germany. And what a coincidence was it that I saw you mostly in Germany. What a great experience for me. Yes, yes. So, but I don't want to shut you down, right? Okay, so. Yes, this is also another song that has left a different impact on me. What did I do? I did a mistake. Anyway. Oh God. So, which one is this? Where my love lies asleep. So this is a longer song. And I wonder how it starts.
Did you promise yourself this year would be more productive? All your design work organized? Everyone does. You actually.
Wait a minute. Maybe I can find some lyrics. Soothing my soul. Yes, some of the comments are definitely the ones that I feel about. Definitely, your voice soothes our souls. And there are no lyrics. No. Anyway. I should have put the lyrics here in front of me, but definitely I will make another reaction to the lyrics probably. So this is mostly to the melody of the songs. Okay, it starts nice, and even the headline reveals something about a hidden love, where my love lies asleep. So it is a sleeping love.
Where my love lies asleep, there's no chains to her spirit. As she enters the doorway of dreams drifting free.
Okay, so his love lies asleep, but she enters the doorway. So it's somebody that he definitely has very close to him. Probably it's his wife, and probably this song talks about his wife.
Flash, rivers roar around the island she's sleeping, and the echo soul that speaks where she's sleeping.
Okay, and probably he watches her while she's sleeping. So a love that is definitely in the same room, in the same environment. So and he takes the moment with her. Okay, here comes a solo, an instrumental, so which really fits well into the song, very nice, with all the with all the instruments and the vocalists humming. It's like a chorus with different melodies that comes together. Beautiful.
Through the hallways of wonder, down the steps of the deep. Secrets that drum where my love lies asleep. Lost the suns in the morning, lost the stars in their sleep.
Yes, Dave has a really sexy voice. Especially here, the last lines, when they get a little bit, you know, his voice, when it gets a little bit, how can you describe it? I don't know how to describe it, but it's really sexy. Like here. It's so sexy here. Yes, yes. And he describes his love being asleep. Definitely, he thinks of somebody very special here. Yes, yes. And very, very much instrumental involved here, but it's nice. I liked it.
Where my love lies asleep.
I have to tell that all the songs that I've listened to up to now are very well planned. I mean, there is no sound accidentally happening here. And if it is accidentally happening, it's something which fits into the song. Definitely something that completes the songs. I mean, every song completes itself within itself. Now, Smile. I wonder how this song sounds, Smile. And I want to have the lyrics here. Now, let me see if there is. Okay, somebody's talking about goosebumps here. No lyrics. Oh. It says here, my favorite song. Well, let's see. No lyrics. Somebody said, to me, the song is boring. Well, let's see if it's boring or not. Wait a minute. Was that Charlie Chaplin's song? I mean, the song that Charlie Chaplin's film. Let's see. Again, the piano, right? And the keys of the piano. Yeah, it must be Charlie Chaplin's song. I mean, the song that is in the film.
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though
it's breaking. Yes, yes, it's that song. And it starts sad. And it makes me want to cry.
When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile maybe tomorrow. You'll see the sun come shining through.
So this reminds me of my son. I'm sure the fans know about the Soul Savers 2 album, and there was a song called My Son, and the lyrics from Smile, they remind me of my son, because he's talking about the dark clouds there, and then and then he says, behind the darkest clouds, the sun always shines again. So in here, he again talks about the sun that will shine behind the clouds, and we will see the sun again. So there is hope. There is hope behind each sorrow. And it actually talks about the world, the life on the world, on Earth. I mean, when you consider what's happening to the world and all the forest fires and everything. So this, I definitely think of a more broad sense of interpretation. I think that's probably a song that was dedicated to the whole world and the world itself, probably. And maybe it tells the world that it should smile, though her heart is breaking. I mean, there are forest fires and everything, and there are accidents happening and things like that, and there are lives that are lost and animals that are being killed, etc., and trees are burnt down and everything, and there are dry areas in life and people, they have to starve and things like that. So everything is unequal, and though everything tends to seem bad, there is still a hope in the sky, and it might turn the world into a certain hope, into a certain smile. That's what I think. Different interpretation. I mean, that's what it made me think of.
For you, light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness.
Yes, and even though you're sad, and even though you're suffering, light up your face with a smile. I mean, with gladness, with a hope, and smile, just smile, and it will make you feel better. Oh God, it wants to make me cry. Okay, I don't want to listen. I mean, I don't want to continue interpreting it in that way and continue listening.
Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying?
Yes, and he's talking about the tears and crying, and it really wants to make me cry now. And it made me think of a certain moments in the past where I cried. And now I think there was no use of crying. Maybe because we are emotional people. That's probably because of that. And sometimes I think we shouldn't be that emotional. One song shouldn't make you cry, or one moment of happiness shouldn't make you cry, because sometimes happiness can make you cry too. Yes, and you are overwhelmed with emotion. Makes me think of Berlin. And the bodyguard. Yes.
You'll find that life is still worthwhile.
Definitely, life is still worthwhile. So every life is precious. No life is a life that should be ended. So you have to live life to the fullest and take every advantage of it that it's given.
If you just smile.
If it were just that easy, if you smile, everything goes away, all your sorrows will go away. That's easy said. And I'm thinking of the Charlie Chaplin films now in front of me, right? Where he's smiling, although he's quite sad in the film. Yes. Very nostalgic. And I love this song, actually, the nostalgia in the song. And now Dave is coming again.
That's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying?
Okay, that's the refrain again, the chorus. It's a nice chorus. What's the use of crying? Smile, though your heart is breaking.
You'll find that life is still worthwhile. If you just smile.
I love the interpretation of this song, interpreted and covered by Dave. I love it. I think it's the best cover made ever of Smile. It's a wonderful cover, I must say. Congratulations. I love this one especially, because I think it reflects life. It makes me think of my own life and of the world and most of our lives. I mean, when you think of people, they have to go on living, they have to go on trying, even though the world's heart is crying, it has to go on turning. It's something like that. I wonder who played the piano here. It's so nice. It's so nice.
That's the time. You must keep on trying. Smile. What's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile. If you...
Yeah, a very sexy sigh here. I've just found it. It's so wonderful.
Just smile.
Very sexy. Yes. It's a wonderful song. So, so sad, but also it leaves a certain door open for hope. And I must say that the person who wrote down that the song was very boring and it was the most boring song on the album, I think he didn't quite understand the meaning behind it. So that's what I think, definitely. So I think it's one of the best covers on the album. That's what I think. Okay, it makes you sigh, not smile. No, another Dave gone here. Okay, and the videos. So how many songs are left? God, there are 4 songs left I have to listen to. Strange Religion. Okay, wait a minute. Before I, of course, listen, I'm scrolling down in case there are lyrics here. Somebody said you nailed it again. Definitely. Oh, what a voice. Another song, another one said, somebody said, you are my personal Jesus. What a voice again. Definitely. What a voice. A very unique one. Definitely. So I think we must all drink after listening to this album, or drink lilac wine. Somebody said he doesn't have voice to sing Mark Lanegan's song. Original is much better. I listened to the original. I listened to Mark Lanegan's version. Let's see if I like it more or not. And then I will give my opinion to it, on it. Sorry.
Can you stay here next to me? Or just keep driving? Because of you, I see a light.
I wish the sound of the music was a little bit back so that Dave's voice came a little bit forward here. That would have been better, because I sometimes think that the sound of the song and the vocalists, they suppress the sound, the voice of Dave a little bit. So that's when I can't understand, or that's when I can't hear him in the way that I should. So it's the same in this song. So let's listen again.
Because of you, I see a light. The beauty is a century.
73 like you.
I wish Dave was more dominant here on this song. It's definitely a good one, but he should have been more dominant here. I mean his voice. It's just the contrary. I mean, the vocalists, they sing louder here on this song, and also the drums, they are louder, and in a way they make Dave's voice die down.
Some strange religion. Get my hands on some money of my own, and I shot it away. Stared down the past and just scarred my eyes. Now I know there's no easy ride. She's been the kind of my ticket in her stride. Some jagged diamonds kicked her heart around. Did they know they were walking on holy ground? Almost gone a day so many times. Didn't know what it felt like to be alive. A friend to me, like nobody else could be.
Right. That's definitely what's happening here. I think Dave's voice should have been more dominant. It is a nice song, though. It's beautiful. And there is no... Oh, it's good that he sings it in the version of like Mark Lanegan. He is faithful to the original, and I think it's nice in that way.
Keep my hands on the wheel number alone, and I honestly try. She looked past the scars and the burned out eyes. You can see I'm no easy ride. She's just the kind who might get you to buy some strange religion. This jacket of diamonds kicked her heart around. Should have known we were walking on holy ground. This life might eventually just be the end of me. Will I still be with you? There's a Gideon next to me. Just keep trying.
I hope the other songs are not like that too, where they suppress Dave's voice. I hope it's only in this song.
There's Buick's a century, 73 like you. Some strange religion. Buick's century, 73 like you. Some strange religion.
It's nice. But as I said, okay, Now comes the last three songs. I wonder about the last song, You're Always on My Mind. Held My Baby Last Night. So I think this is another romantic song. And I'm so happy one song lasts over 5 minutes. Wow, that's great. So I will be very, very happy listening to that song.
So you've never heard of premiumbeat.com?
Okay, before we start, of course, scroll down and maybe we can find lyrics. What a terrific voice, says somebody. Amazing, Dave Gahan. Yes, definitely. Wonderful performance. Wow. Dirty Blues, says somebody. I love you. I love you too. Fucking great pleasure to listen to this song. I can't wait to hear it. Somebody didn't like it. He wrote it in a language I don't understand, but no lyrics again. Power of Love, said somebody. Let's see. I hope your voice doesn't die down again. Listen.
I held my baby last night.
Wow. That reminds me of Elvis singing rock and roll, right? That's wonderful. So different.
Till everything's all right. I held my baby last night. Until everything was all right.
Yes, again, here, I think, Dave's voice should have been a little bit more superior to the other instruments. Sometimes they are too dominant. That's what I think. So maybe next time you work with Soul Savers, David, please make sure that you put a little bit more pressure on your voice rather than the other instruments and the vocalists. I think they should be more in the background and your voice should be more on the foreground. On the foreground? Yes, on the foreground. Just a little bit.
She woke up early in the morning, baby.
She woke up in the morning. That's great.
Come back to me.
Yeah, and we say, please come back. Please, please come back. That's great. I imagine now Dave singing to this song and doing rock and roll with his hips and everything, with his belly dancing. That would be wonderful. And I'm sure he would definitely dance better than Elvis in his own style, not in Elvis style, right? Like when he did in The Question of Time, etc.
Yeah!
Wow. So he's crying out. A very rocky song. Is it blues, rock, blues together?
Oh,
I must say the band is really strong. They do a great job. I mean, Soul Savers together with Dave and the band, they are perfect. Almost as perfect as Depeche Mode. I love you, baby. So nice. And you know, all your love is free. We love you too, Dave. I love you too. Now it's about 10 in the morning, baby. And everything's gone all wrong. My imagination goes crazy now. I imagine Dave on stage going crazy. Dancing. And we cheering. Yeah! Wow, what a great cry. I must say, it's a cry. I wish Dave's voice was more dominant here so that we could hear him crying out louder, right? Because the instruments, they all suppress his voice. You know, I've been with you so long, baby. And now you're driving me away from home. Wow, that's great. God, where did he last? Ah, God, where was it? Which song was it where I feel you? It was with I Feel You. Yes, that's one of my favorite songs when, you know, he goes crazy and singing, crying out. And I wish I could hear this life, see this life. I mean, see you life, Dave. So I also wish that you sing this song, Life, I Held My Baby Last Night, because I wonder how that song is life. Yes? Hopefully. It will be broadcasted live. I mean, the concert in London. So let's see what comes out. Euphoria. Joy. It finishes all of a sudden, actually. I mean, it could have gone on for a few more minutes. It's too short for this kind of song, I think. Wonderful. It's a wonderful song. Definitely. Oh, it's the last song. No, two more songs. Not Dark Yet. So, Not Dark Yet.
Hayata dolu tarafından bakmanın formülü eşittir. Sen artıcıs. Artı. Artıcos. Artı içim tereyağının bol sütten gelen lezzeti. İçimle hayata dolu tarafından bak.
I think I really wonder how Dave sounds in this song, because Bob Dylan, I didn't really like Bob Dylan's voice, and the song that he interpreted the song, and I'm sure that Dave will do it better. Let's see if there are any lyrics to Dark, Not Dark Yet. Freddie Morales wrote Amazing Process. Hit me right in the feels. Oh my God, this one is so good. Okay, great job, just perfect. Look, it says here, it's much better than Dylan. I'm sure, even before listening, I think this voice will hit it to the nail. So, better than Dylan. Definitely, I'm sure that it's better than Dylan. Because I don't think Dylan has a good voice. His interpretation might be good, but so first like and then listen. Where is it? Like? Where is the like? Here. And then listen. Okay. The music is definitely better. Of course, it was years ago that Bob Dylan sang the song, but definitely the interpretation of the band is also, I think, quite better, much better.
Shadows are falling, and I've been here all day. It's too hot to sleep, and time is running away.
Now here, I think Dave needs to be more on the front. His voice should be more dominant. Dave's voice deserves in this song to be on the front, a little bit, just a little bit.
I feel like my soul has turned into steel. I still got the scars that the sun didn't let me heal. Not even room enough to be anywhere. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there.
It's really difficult to understand, Dave. You must really listen hard so that you can understand the lyrics. He says it's not dark yet, but it's getting there, or something like that. So when Dylan sings it, his voice is more dominant, right? But Dave singing it, his voice dies down. So this is definitely one of the negative sides of the band. I mean, or the vocalists and the instruments coming together makes up a too strong combination, so that the voice of Dave just a little bit dies down. right? But it's a nice song. I like it. I like Dave's version much better than Dylan's.
Well, my sense of humanity is going down the drain. Behind every beautiful thing, there's been some kind of pain. She wrote me a letter, and she wrote it so kind.
Yes, now this song, definitely, when I heard the original of Bob Dylan, and the lyrics go, she wrote me a letter and she wrote it so kind. That makes me think of the thank you for the takeover of Depeche Mode. And I wrote a thank you note in that notebook. It was a notebook, something like this, only with a painting on the cover of all three. So I had three notebooks like this, and one of them I gave to Martin in front of the hotel and thanked him, and we also wished him happy birthday. So I think he accepted it as a birthday present. And then I gave one to Fletch, and I wrote down a note to Fred Fletch. And to Dave, I wrote a very nice note, and I gave it to his bodyguard. So it all reminded me of this, I mean, these moments when I heard the line Bob Dylan was singing. And now as Dave is singing it, it also reminds me of that, those moments, of course. It was so beautiful, wonderful. And I, if I could turn back the time, I definitely would go back there again to those moments.
She wrote it so kind.
And I'm sure Dave, and I'm sure that he received thousands, maybe millions of letters of his fans that were love letters and declared their love. Yes.
She put down her writing, what was in her mind. I just don't see why I should even care.
And he says, I don't see why I should even care. Yes, that's what stars generally do. They don't care. Do fans care? Maybe. Maybe we shouldn't care either.
It's not dark yet, but it's getting there. Well, I've been to London.
I've been to London too.
And I've been to gay Paris.
And I've been to gay Paris too.
I followed the river.
And in Paris, we saw Martin, we saw Christian. We talked to Christian and we waved at Martin. And in one hope, we all hoped that we would see Dave, but there was no trace of Dave. So it was a hopeless case to see you. And it was also like this in Berlin, and also so in Krakow. Where else? I think those three. I definitely love Bob Dylan's lyrics here. I loved the lyrics.
looking for nothing in anyone's eyes. Sometimes my burden is more than I can bear.
It's hard to understand what he sings here. I hardly can make out the lyrics here, right? As I said, all the vocalists, all the sounds, and all the instruments, they come together and they make Dave's voice die down. It's really hard to understand the syllables. Can't it be arranged on the vinyl or on the CD or on the DVD that the sound of the voice of Dave can be a little bit lifted up? I mean, isn't that manageable? That's only a question, and if anyone in the band hears it, or the producers, maybe they could manage that. It's quite getting rocky here. That's nice. Okay, so this line reminds me of my life. I was born here too, and I wonder if I will die here. I hope not. But sometimes it makes me think, because faith brings you back to the place where you were born. It's weird. I hope not. So that's what Dylan said.
Against my will.
Against my will. That's what happens, right? Because you say, oh, I would never go back to that place where I was born, and you come here. And then you work here, and then you look back, and you get reminded of how many years have passed. I mean, that you have spent here. So it's almost more than 20 years that you have lived here. And it makes you think, oh God, am I going to die here? So, and that's what happens against your will. Sometimes in life, things happen.
No, it looks like I'm moving. But I'm standing still.
Very nice of Dylan what he said. It looks as if I'm moving, but I'm standing still. It's like a dream. I mean, in your dream, you're trying to run and you can't.
Every nerve in my body is naked and numb. I can't even remember what it was. Came here to get away from. Don't even heed mother of our prayer. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there.
It's wonderfully interpreted by Dave. Wonderful. Really nice. I mean, one of my favorites, I can say, apart from the moments where Dave's voice dies down, is suppressed by the band and by the other voices, the vocalists. It shouldn't have been so, because I think Dave's voice deserves much better place. Always on my mind, the last song before I say goodbye. Okay. Maybe
Did you promise yourself this
I
year would be
didn't
more
treat
productive?
you.
All your work and life organized?
Yes, Dave singing. Oh, 2.2. Wow. That's such a nice song. I definitely. Wow. So many likes. Great. Elvis. Wow. Somebody said a song I never really liked until now. Yes. And I know the lyrics to the song, definitely. So let's see. Let's see. Oh my goodness, says somebody. Now I wonder how this song. Feels like, sounds like. Okay, maybe I didn't treat you. Sing it, David. You are always on my mind. Maybe I can sing it together. I hope the band doesn't kill your voice.
Maybe I didn't treat you.
That's great. That's great. They didn't interfere that much. That's great. It's a nice voice. The way I imagined it.
Quite as good as I should Maybe I didn't love you.
Yes. It's a perfect voice. Smooth, emotional, sexy. What else can I say?
Quite as often as I could have. Little things I should have said and done. I just never took the time. You were always on my mind. You
You were
were
always
always on
on
my
my
mind.
mind.
Maybe I didn't hold you all those lonely times.
I like it with only the piano, because if all the instruments came together, I definitely think that they that if that they would have killed Dave's voice. So only the piano is good.
And I guess I never told you. I'm so happy that you're mine. If I make you feel second best.
I still think that the ahs of the vocalists, they are too loud. I don't think they should have been so loud. At least they could have been a track lower.
Girl, I'm sorry, I was blind. You were always on my mind. You were always
To
on my
my
mind.
mind.
Tell me that your sweet love hasn't died.
Tell me that your sweet love hasn't died. Yes, he's definitely calling out for someone that he longs for, that he misses, probably someone in the past, long, long ago, a long time ago, and he wants forgiveness. And he is begging her to tell him that her love hasn't died. Yes. If he calls out for his fans and says, tell me that your love hasn't died, I would definitely say, no, our love hasn't died. We will always love you, David.
Give me one more chance to keep you satisfied. Should have said and done. I just never took the time.
You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
You were always on my mind.
You
It's too short. There should have been another. There should have been another. How do you call it? Another phrase, not another phrase, but another. There should have been another repetition, probably. 3 minutes is too short for that song. Definitely should have been longer. Like, for example, 5 minutes. I mean, he could have repeated the lines like at the beginning. So as I said, all in all, it's a wonderful album, wonderful songs. The only thing that I criticize is that the band and the vocalists, they are too strong. The noise is coming too strong, and there is an imbalance of Dave's voice and the band's. So I think it should have been a little bit, 60% Dave's voice and 40% the band and the vocalists. So that would have equaled it, definitely. Now it was something like 40% Dave's voice and 60% the band. But all in all, it's wonderful, and I'm happy that I listened to another Soul Savers album like this. So well done, David, congratulations, and see you hopefully some other time in another concert. Okay, good night. And I hope from somewhere you're listening and watching this.